Good morning. Welcome to St. Dominic's Church. Today is the fifth Sunday of Easter and it is also Mother's Day. So a very happy Mother's Day to all of the mothers out there. Thank you for joining us for our Mass today. Our gathering hymn will be City of God. And just like last week, you can find the link to the lyrics down in the comments section below. Please stand and join in singing as you are able, City of God.
Mother's Day. Last week we had plenty of roses. Still, I managed to get some of them. And our kids, James, William, Catherine, Evelyn, they have made a beautiful poster. Thanks to them. God bless them. Let us begin this Eucharistic celebration. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
In order to celebrate this second mystery, brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and seek God's mercy and forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you are the way, truth, and the life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the gateway to the Father. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you promise us eternal life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And on earth peace
Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Now during those days, when the disciples were increasing in number, the Hellenists complained against the Hebrews, because their widows were being neglected in the daily distribution of food. And the 12 called together the whole community of the disciples and said, "It is not right that we should neglect the word of God in order to wait on tables. Therefore, brothers, select from among yourselves 7 men of good standing, full of the Spirit and of wisdom, whom we may appoint to this task, while we, for our part, will devote ourselves to prayer and to serving the word." What they said pleased the whole community, and they chose Stephen, a man full of faith and the Holy Spirit, together with Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas, a convert of Antioch. They had these men stand before the apostles, who prayed and laid their hands on them. The word of God continued to spread. The number of the disciples increased greatly in Jerusalem, and a great many of the priests became obedient to the faith. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in singing the responsorial psalm. The words to the response are, Lord, let your love be upon us as we place all our trust in you.
Second reading, a reading from the first letter of Saint Peter. Beloved, come to the Lord, a living stone, though rejected by human beings, yet chosen and precious in God's sight. Like living stones, let ourselves be built into a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it stands in Scripture, see, I am laying in Zion a stone, a cornerstone, chosen and precious, and whoever believes in him will not be put to shame. To you then who believe, he is precious, but for those who do not believe, the stone that the builders rejected has become the very head of the corner and a stone that makes them stumble and a rock that makes them fall. They stumble because they disobeyed the word, and as they were destined to do. But you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's own people, in order that you may proclaim the mighty acts of Him who called you out of darkness into His marvelous light. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? But Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, you will know my Father also. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Philip said to him, Lord, show us the Father, and we will be satisfied. Jesus said to him, Have I been with you all this time, Philip? And you still do not know me? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I say to you, I do not speak on my own, but the Father who dwells in me does his works. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. But if you do not, then believe me because of my works themselves. Very truly I tell you, the one who believes in me will also do the works that I do, and in fact,
will do greater works than these, because I am going to the Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As we celebrate Mother's Day, it is our primary duty to pray for all the mothers, our own mothers, those who are living, those who are gone before us. We honor them, we respect them, and seek God's abundant blessings through the powerful intercession of our beloved Mama Mary. Archbishop Fulton J. Sheen once shared this. One time, he was going to give a talk in a parish, but could not find the way to the church. And he saw a little boy on the road and asked for the directions. And you know, this little boy, when he saw this huge guy, became very curious. Seeing him in his episcopal outfit with that cap, mitre, you know, red sash, he became very curious. And the boy asked, "Sir, you are not a Superman, are you?" You know, the children. Bishop smiled and explained, "No, I am a priest." "What does a priest do?" asked the boy. "Well, I tell people how to go to heaven." The boy did not believe him. He said, "No way. You cannot even find the church. How would you help people find heaven?" Yes, in today's gospel, you see, Jesus is saying, "I am the way, I am the truth, and the life." In other words, he's saying, he's the ultimate absolute in this world. It is only he. Jesus alone reigns. Over the years, you and I have witnessed and seen there is tremendous increase in the number of the followers of Jesus. Number is increasing day by day. There are billions of followers of Jesus all over the world. And there are many, many Catholics. And among the many Catholics, there are Catholics who are called pick and choose Catholics. They would say, "I will believe in the miracles of Jesus, but not in the sacraments, not in the Eucharist." They would say, "I will rejoice in the resurrection of Jesus, but I will not accept the cross. I will receive the sacraments except confession." You know, for Jesus, when people behave this way, it is absolute, superior absurdity. It is either we accept him and his teachings altogether or reject him altogether. Either we are with him or against him. There are no multiple choices. No. There are no multiple choices. There are no compromises. For he is the way, truth, and the life. There is no one else. He is the savior of the world. Today's gospel, brothers and sisters, poses two challenges before us. First challenge is We must make a choice between Jesus and the world. You see, people are becoming materialistic and worldly, who are in constant pursuit of their selfish ambitions for power, wealth, money. But if we accept Jesus as the way, we must reject the ways of the world. There are so many people who embrace superstitious beliefs, horoscopes, feng shui, you name it, a lot of other pagan practices. If we accept Jesus as the truth, we cannot anymore entertain these erroneous teachings and false beliefs. No way. And the second challenge before us is that losing Jesus should never be an option in our life. Jesus is everything for us. We all accept it. He is everything for us. That is why we come with that reverence and faith, trust in the Lord, worshiping Him, praising Him. And to lose Him is to lose everything. You see, people are today, they're terrified of losing their wealth, their power, their status, and their loved ones. How about this? Are we afraid of losing Jesus? We must remember, whenever we transgress God's commandments, when we persist in living in grave sin, and when we obstinately hold on the erroneous beliefs and lead our immoral life, we lose Jesus. We go against Jesus. We may come to church. We may present ourselves the best people we could ever be before the Lord. But when we go out in the world, we become totally different. To lose Jesus is to lose the only way to salvation. When we lose Jesus, we lose our way to salvation. Thomas, in today's gospel, he voices his concern when Jesus was about to leave them. On behalf of the apostles, he asked, "What direction should we take in your absence?" And Jesus, simply pointing to himself, he says, "I am the way, I am the truth, and the life." He does not leave any answers. What did they ask for? Jesus did not tell them many things because Jesus wanted them to face the future with honesty, with togetherness. You know, my dear brothers and sisters, as followers of Christ, Jesus trusts us. Jesus trusts me and you as his followers down the ages that we face the confusion and complexity of this world. And now, life on this earth is never easy. Life in this world is never easy. Jesus knows all this. That is why Jesus does not leave answer to everything. There's still a lot of working out to be done. And Jesus knows all that. And to this gospel, you see, when we are saddened with confusion, fears, sorrows of our life, we must take courage and strength from the invitation that Jesus says, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God, have faith in me." Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, it is through Him and with Him we come to the Father.
and we come to enjoy eternal life and glory in his eternal kingdom. Let us always, as the psalm beautifully is sang, let us place our trust upon him. Let us surrender ourselves into his hands, for he is our Lord and Savior. Yes, we thank the Lord for bringing us together here. People of God, wherever you are listening to the word of God. Be strengthened in your faith. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Do not give up. Have courage. Have faith in God. He is still alive. He is still with us. And he is guiding us and leading us. And all the mothers, may God bless you all and keep you safe and sound under his loving providential care. Amen.
Can you stand and profess our faith?
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Let us now place our prayers before the Lord. Baptized, chosen as a priestly people, let us come to our Father on behalf of all our brothers and sisters, praying through Christ, the way, the truth, and the life.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For God's chosen and consecrated people, that the Church may always offer prayerful and reverent worship, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the rulers of nations, that they may recognize the service provided by the Church and so respect her rights and freedom, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For people stumbling on their search for faith, that they may come to God through Jesus Christ, the only way to the Father, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all mothers and those who have shared a mother's love, may God watch over them, bless them with every good gift, and fill their hearts with peace. Your response?
Lord, hear our prayer.
For ourselves as living stones in a spiritual house, that we may work with the energy and courage of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the dead, Heldred Crampett, Dominic Barr, Nicola Sicoria, Anne-Marie Cameron, Genevieve Martins, James Roy Hallohan, that they may enter that place Christ has prepared for them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us now in silence pray for our personal intentions. Pray for all those families who lost their mothers recently. May God comfort, console, and may the souls of our beloved brothers and sisters rest in peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We thank you, Father, most holy, for the wonders of your generous care. Show again your love for us as we call upon you. We make these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Please join in singing Hail Mary, Gentle Woman. The link to the words can be found below in the comments section.
Thank you. full of grace. The Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and of all God's holy church.
O God, by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice, have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead. Grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to laud you at more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross, and by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the Lamb of Sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exult in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink
death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Thomas our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us. All we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Dominic, and all the saints who have pleased with all the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs with them in life, and may praise and glorify you, your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Divine teaching, we now dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold, he takes away the sins of the world.
Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please join us singing Be Not Afraid. The lyrics can be found in the link in the comment section below.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, for you do not
let us pray. graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord. Lead those you have imbued with the heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to the newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray to St. Michael the Archangel.
St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and the snares of the devil. God, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast to hell Satan and all evil spirits who dwell about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
For all the mothers, happy Mother's Day. Please bow your heads for our blessing. Loving God, as a mother gives life and nourishment to her children, so you watch over your church. Bless these women that they may be strengthened as Christian mothers, and those mothers gone before us, grant them eternal rest. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. And may Almighty God bless Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Please join in singing our sending forth hymn, We Are Called. The link to the words can be found in the comments section below.